The 2022 Bristol Night Race this past weekend had 1.776 million viewers on the USA Network, meaning it was down 19.3% from the 2.2 million on NBC Sports Network last year. And to make matters even worse for NASCAR, the NHRA beat them in the 18-49 demo with 578,000 viewers in that demo, compared to NASCAR's 411,000, even with a bit of a smaller audience. This, in my opinion, is part of a larger, nearly two-decade-long problem: NASCAR's postseason, the playoffs. Now, it might seem odd to complain about something that was made all the way back in the fall of 2003 and instituted in 2004, but the thing is, this was meant to be made to help the sport. But ultimately, the playoffs have not helped. And it's shown in the biggest tell for NASCAR. And in a tell that, in general, we fans can see most changes being made because of. When you look at schedule changes in TV ratings, it's usually because a track, say like Road America, didn't provide a good TV audience. And this has happened in NASCAR over and over again. So let's look at how the NASCAR playoffs have a ratings problem. Now, starting off, they actually didn't. In 2004, about 7 million viewers watched each chase race on average, meaning the last 10 races were 11% over 2003. And seeing how 2004 overall was plus 2%, you can definitely say in its first year that the playoffs, in the form of the chase, helped NASCAR. And I think that you can explain this down to the fact that it's a new thing and people were curious. Plus, there's a good championship fight, and a lot of people probably didn't know that there was a change and tuned in anyways. Then you have 2005. That had 7.4 million. It was 5% over 2004. And there's a little bit of problems here with this. Yes, it's a good increase, and that is good, but the problem is that the 2005 season overall was plus 7% in viewership, meaning the 2005 chase, yeah, it was up for a bit, but the last two races of the season were down. Now, you could also chalk this up just to not a good championship fight. Well, 2006 had a good championship fight and was down 10%. Then, 2007 had another one with two really popular drivers in Jeff Gordon and Jimmy Johnson. It was down another 13%. And the season overall in 2007 was only down 4%, meaning that the season would have increased in TV ratings and viewers had the chase not had the huge dip downwards. So you can say again, 2007, this is really where you can tell the chase or playoff format started hurting NASCAR. And the same can be said for 2008. The 2008 season in viewers alone was up 3%, but in viewers for the playoffs, it was down 1%. Once again, the playoffs, the last 10 races of the season, the battle for the championship, actively hurt NASCAR on the bottom line. Now, 2009 both went down, though the season overall went down a little more, and that can be attributed to Fox Sports not doing its job. But 2010 saw another decrease. You see, ESPN and ABC, even with averaging around 5.5 million a race in 2009, didn't see the value of putting NASCAR on ABC and instead put it to cable on ESPN, meaning that this would have a 20% decrease in ratings for the chase and would actively torpedo the ratings for the entire season in 2010, once again hurting the sport. Now, the chase was up 5% again in 2011, like it was in 2005, and the season overall, like 2005, was up 7%. So, yes, you can say that maybe the chase hurt it, but I'll say in this one it's indifferent. More people in general were watching. Well, in 2012, the chase went down 10% and hurt the season overall as it went down at a faster pace than NASCAR did in general. Now, the 2013 season is the last season the chase actually helped NASCAR. Hear me out. There were about 4.6 million viewers every race in 2013, putting the chase up 9% over 2012. And with NASCAR's TV ratings being flat in 2013, it meant that the chase did actively help the sport, at least not grow, but not fall. And like I said, this is it. This is the last time that there's an increase in ratings for the final 10 races. Ever since, we have seen a march downwards every single season, and while NASCAR has done the same, NASCAR, for the most part, has leveled off, at least in the last 4 years or so. And you can see this in general every single season, where if it's not down faster than the overall regular season, the playoffs are still falling at a pretty bad level. In 2015, for instance, it fell 1% faster than the regular season, but this was helped by the fact that 2015 had a finale that, due to a rain delay, encroached onto the NFL's TV window, actively increasing the audience because, well, the NASCAR TV window wasn't what they were looking for. The audience was actively mad, and it's the only reason why the 2015 playoffs actually are relatively close to being on par with the rest of the season. You saw a huge decrease in 2016, you saw another big decrease in 2019, and in 2021, it was flat. But so far this year, NASCAR's TV ratings in the opening playoff races is down 20%, a faster fall in TV ratings for the playoffs than ever seen before in its now 18-year history if you include this season. The playoffs now are actively hurting the sport's growth. Now, the playoffs overall also hurt the next year up. Let me put it like this. If there is less hype at the end of your season than, say, in the middle of the season when it's kind of just flyover races, then it's really going to hurt the lead up to the next year. Yeah, NASCAR's biggest race is the Daytona 500, and that, of course, is going to bring in big ratings to start the season. But when the playoffs actively can't best races that are in the middle of the summer with no competition, well, you're going to have some problems, because when NASCAR is supposed to hype itself up for the next year during that end of the season, well, instead, people are watching baseball playoffs or football, or now, F1. But it brings the question, why are the playoff ratings down? Well, it's because the sport and the championship have lost legitimacy. And instead of going for a valid champion, they're going for basically whatever the best show is. Instead of seeing a great championship fight, what people see is right through to the fact that the playoffs are only here for entertainment purposes, not to crown who is actually the best in the overall season. The definition of legitimacy, from what I've looked up, has said that it is A, conformity to laws or the rules, which of course NASCAR and its drivers do this with the playoff format. But it also is the ability to be defended with logic or justification and validity. I don't see, in my opinion, how you can have a championship format. Say it's a championship, which is supposed to crown the best one all year, yet actively go out of your way to handicap the best all year in just about every step of the way, so that lesser teams and drivers who haven't performed as well can have a chance and many times beat the best all year. And yeah, you can use the 07 Patriots argument. Sorry, the 2007 New England Patriots did not play all 32 NFL teams the way that NASCAR drivers will go against the other 35 to 39 drivers on track. There's a reason playoffs are implemented in stick and ball sports, and it's because a lot of times, with the way that scheduling is, it is hard or completely impossible for the competition to actively play each other in every single game all year. This is why in all legitimate forms of motorsports, there are no playoffs. It is just a full season format, because the aggregate can always filter out those who are up there just because of pure chance alone. Moments like Kyle Busch winning after missing 30% of 2015, or Kevin Harvick missing the final four in 2020 when he was head and shoulders above everyone, as well as Kyle Larson needing to squeak by for a title that he deserved for the good part of half the season, are good for NASCAR to pump up stories that anything could happen. But people know that this isn't a legitimate format. The rules aren't legitimate in showing who is best, only who can put up the best entertainment. It's for ratings, and it's actively failing every season. To me, as is with a lot of others, the only solution is a full season points format. You don't need to go right back to the Winston Cup style points where it's 5, 4, and 3 points between everybody. You can keep the points payouts as they are now, but just count them up at the end of the year and see what you got as a champion. Because under the current format, even the drivers don't take it seriously. Kevin Harvick is famous for saying that it's skewed towards entertainment, and he'd rather win races and have the kind of 2020 season he had. The championship would have been a bonus. What is supposed to be the crowning achievement of stock car racing in this country is seen as a bonus by one of the top 10 drivers all time. When the competition, especially that high profile, shows apathy towards the system, there's an issue. How do you expect fans like myself to take this seriously when there are some of the best drivers ever who don't? The playoffs actively have hurt the sport, like I said before, and nobody in the networks, executive brass, or anyone in power in the sport seems to want to actively step up and face the challenge of the narrative. Instead, everyone keeps their head down, acts like this is normal in a professional auto racing series and sport to change it every couple years, and tries to ignore the elephant in the room that is actively dying, the TV ratings at the end of the season. So here's my solution. With a new TV deal and probably a new partner like ESPN, NASCAR can have a revamped but also retro championship, trying to bring back legitimacy to the sport. The racing product's been fixed mostly, attendance is going back up, driver personalities are actually a lot better, and now it's just time to fix this major problem too. Do something like this to bring back old fans and show new ones that we actively care about who is the best all year. Now, with this and knowing that in general the playoffs make the ratings fall faster than any other time in the year, I want to hear what you think. Do you think it's time to change them? Do we go back to a full season points playout, or do we just go with what we have now? Let me know down in the comments below. And while you're at it, leave a like on this video, share this video, and subscribe to my channel for more great NASCAR content. And to all my channel members, thank you for your continuous support. So until next time, have a good one.